Good morning, everyone. How is everyone doing? Good. What was an acceptable answer? Thank you for joining us here today for day three of Equestria LA. And today you're joining us for a wonderful voice actor panel. Joining us, of course, is the wonderful Calvin Sings and Nina.
Good morning!
Alright.
And we also have two other feisty friends of mine.
Feisty.
Wonderful Michelle Beaver.
Hello.
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 What's up, Dad?
So we have
happy birthday, Michelle.
First of all, good morning.
There we go, right?
I understand. So we actually have something really fun for you guys. A fun little treat for Sunday morning. We have here a copy in front of everybody. And it is the My Little Pony Micro Series, issue number 6.
Ooh.
We're going to have a live reading. How fun is that? So each one of these wonderful people up here is going to be assigned a role. So the characters that we have are Granny Smith. Apple Bloom.
Yay!
Hey!
Applejack.
Yow.
Yow.
And I will be playing the role of Big Mac and Nary.
Yup.
Ooh.
So without further ado, that's the ticket, Apple Bloom. Hold her steady. We'll keep this pace up from way up to our eyeballs and applesauce and no time.
Oh, they sure do love our apple trees this time of year, Greg.
Well, I can't blame them. Heartwarming's Eve is all about folks coming together. When folks come together, you bet your baby they want tasty treats to enjoy. But as busy as we may get, we must never forget that it's also the time to spend the time with the time and the time and don't see with the ones you love the most.
Applejack slams open the door.
Yeah, what are y'all doing standing
there? Sorting apples, peeling apples, corn apples, smudging apples, smashing apples, creating apples, delivering apples.
Now you simmer on down there, every kid. That would be just so easy for the holidays and
down. I know, Granny, but this season is important to the farm and the family. I couldn't bear it if I knew I wasn't doing all I could.
We appreciate it, sis, but you don't have to work all the time, do you?
That's right. Take some time to enjoy yourself.
Yep.
Don't worry about me. I'm going to enjoy myself as long as my family's happy. This is going to be the best
heartwarming eve ever.
The Apple family goes to sleep for the night. Outside, we see a mysterious creature man taking an apple and replacing it with a squash. Morning comes around, and we see a groggy Applejack entering an empty kitchen.
Why, I could have slept till next harvest morning and eat. But farmer's work waits for no pony. Isn't that right, y'all?
Y'all?
Y'all.
Applejack checks outside for the missing family.
Applejack, look!
Who could have done such a thing?
Well, they need all this. It's the sass squatch.
Sass
squatch? Hello, young ones. I'm going to tell you all about it.
The Applejack heads back inside and gather around Granny Smith.
Away the arm, bag, when we were first getting a farm off the ground. Seemed like the world would never end. We had to raid the barn, and the orchard dig the well. Dark and dusk, it wasn't worth work, poking and working. All so that we could have the finest orchard in Equestria. You can imagine our surprise when we waked up one day to find that dozens of apple trees was replaced with squashes. Who or what was behind this mysterious happening? Well, honk my nose inside my hut, I was gonna find out. Hey, I staked out the area for weeks. I had damn near given up hope till one day. That's when I saw it. Never in all the foggy days have I ever seen anything like it.
What was it, Granny?
Luckily, I had my camera at the time.
Granny Smith shows a photo of the Sasquatch.
Nah, you can't tell from the photo. But it was a dancing right there in front of me. It was not just a normal dance. It was no. It was a sassy dance.
Sassy.
I must have spooked it, because we never did see it, nor its squashes never again. Till now, that is. Yeah.
Well, it ain't gonna cause any more mischief this holiday. I'm gonna catch it.
Oh, we can put it on a plate. Then it would want to come watch it, right?
Or I can play my fiddle. Apparently, I can play a fiddle now.
Starts zooming around the room, yelling out different ideas. Big Mac starts walking away.
Maybe if we cover the ground with dump balls, it would trip on them. Oh, we can train one over to spin it off, to spin it out. Magnets! How do they work? I know! Let's dig a big pit and fill it with quicksand. We'll put apples in the middle for bait. Apple trap!
Well, I bet if we put our heads together, we'll be able to figure something else out. But working together is what heartwarming TV is all about, after all. Also, I can bang pots and pans together, crit, crit, take commotions.
Applejack splashes them all with a water bottle.
Y'all don't fret. I'll catch it. I want y'all to enjoy the holiday. I'm not going to let anything be ruined by no good barn.
Oh, buddy, Applejack, you can't do
nobody
yourself.
Ain't
that
lucky,
Nick? Yup. They're right. We have to do this together.
I won't hear any of it. This holiday means too much. You three continue with the harsh harmony preparations. And before you know it, I'll bag us a Sasquatch. Applejack heads off on her quest to catch the Sasquatch. She begins setting up a cage to trap it. This will be a snag. What is that? There ain't a problem in Equestria, and that can't be solved with a little determination and elbow grease. There we go. It's a cage of bait. Free bears even, I reckon. We're over in a bushel of our own irresistible apples of bait. Things are about to turn up, Applejack. Applejack lifts up the trap and gets into hiding position. Once I cage him, I'll give him a glute stern talk to. Maybe even a wag of my hook. I'm feeling stern and will tone him into the forest where he belongs. Not only that, now let sweet patience play with precious melody. It's like the pony said, waiting is the hardest part. Apple cobbler, apple burrito, apple. Apple. Now you got all this new, and time passes by.
Engine, wake up!
Cat bagels! Maybe I just rested my eyes for a moment, but I...
What do you do inside that cage?
What are you talking about, Apple Bloom? I'm on the outside.
Uh-oh.
I've been bamboozled.
Are you sure you couldn't use some help?
No way. No, I'm negatory, little missy. I promise y'all that I will capture this Sasquatch, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. And I don't need a lick of help. That is,
oh boy, stubborn.
Right after you got me out of this cage. Apple Bloom helps Applejack out of the cage. I'm going about this too reasonable. I kept her Sasquatch. I have to think like a Sasquatch.
Applejack begins to impersonate the Sasquatch.
Oh boy.
Dude, I love the woods.
For me, Bob is comfortable and delicious. Now I'm getting it.
Applejack suddenly notices the rest of the Apple family staring at her.
What the heck are y'all looking at? Wait a little, stop a minute, that's it. I gotta look to see.
Well, she done lost it.
Applejack sets up a bunch of mirrors all over New York. Orchard.
That's the last one. All these mirrors bounce back here. That overripe vegetable comes anywhere near the orchard. I'm sure I see it.
Suddenly, 10 reflections of Big Mac appear in the mirror in front of Applejack.
Big Mac top, stop checking yourself out. Actually, not invented in mirrors. Let me guess, you want to fail using here. Your net. I said it again. I'm going to back this monster on my lonesome. I appreciate the concern, but you and the family should be busy making sure everything's ready for the holiday. I can do this by myself, and I'm about to prove it.
Applejack looks back at the mirror only to see a single swatch reflecting off.
Double damn blasted!
Mirror's all gone!
I can see that.
Some time passes by. And Granny Smith is now searching for Applejack.
Where the heck are you? Come talk some sense into you. Here's the next baby.
Applejack comes out of a nearby tree.
Scream! Don't move a muscle.
What did he hide?
Got this place in booby trap. He's tired of ripping tripwires and snares.
Oh my, I'm worried about you, Applejack. I know what it's like to get caught up in the hunt for the Sasquatch. But at the end of the day, that creature ain't gonna be caught if it ain't gonna mind you. Now, I don't want you to lose sight of what's important to you. It is not your job to make everything perfect.
Great. I appreciate all of that, but
Applejack is caught by one of her own booby traps.
Whoa! I've got everything under control.
Is it booby?
At this point, there's a few pages of the many ways that Applejack tries and fails to catch the Sasquatch. It's got a new song to go along with it, too. If you're going to have to buy the comics,
dang, Daddy, nothing works. I've tried everything. It was one step ahead. Darn, dang, shoot, fiddlesticks and marmalade. It's not your job to make everything perfect. Then whose job is it, Granny?
Yes, he did. Applejack returns to the house.
And that's where the phrase, never trust an onion, comes from.
Excuse me, y'all. I'm sorry. I couldn't catch that Sasquatch. It's just too damn elusive. I failed you.
Oh, now, Applejack. Don't you be hard on yourself. That squash has eluded capture for generations.
I know. It's just, I wanted to catch it so y'all could enjoy the holidays in peace. Heartstorm Eve is tomorrow. Who knows what we'll do to our remaining supplies overnight?
Oh, none of that's important now, sugar booger. What's important is this baby. And we get to give it.
Absolutely right. Yeah. I've been going about this all pig-headed. This holiday's not about doing things by yourself.
It's about coming together and working with those you love the most. This will be fun.
As the sun begins to set, the Apple family prepares outside.
Okay, that's all right. Let's huddle up. Never probably know what they're supposed to do.
Yup.
Now let me turn the paper. Let's show this farmer that's missing with the wrong family. The Apple family.
Go! Whoa.
You're a grin.
I'm coming to get you, you great green goofers.
Be ready, Apple Bloom. Never know when
the Sasquatch comes crashing out of the forest. Apple Bloom uses her fiddle to calm it down and lure it into the trap. The Sasquatch falls into the trap, and Mick Mack traps it in his next
trap.
Look in the mirror, make weird voices. Oh.
Well, you owe me some food for the week of the trash can in the
I'm always doing stupid things. Sometimes I have to disguise my voice so that they don't know it's me. I am a secret agent, you see.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm always just being goofy, making like videos and sketches and plays and stuff, and just do silly voices. And I'm sure you do silly voices, you know, too. Yeah. And the difference, I guess, is because you recognize their voice as sounding like the ponies. You think of the pony, but it's just a silly voice they're doing. You know, that got put in a character. So it's the same thing as when you do a silly voice, I guess. You know.
Do you do any silly voices?
No, don't. That's the fun part, that's weird. I love being weird.
Someone wants to banish Luna to the moon. Is it possible for Luna to banish Celestia to the sun?
This is asked earlier.
4,000 years.
It seems only fair.
Oh! Are you going to kill her? poor Celestia.
Where's Ashley Ball? Because she would have been a better voice actor than Black Griffin.
Oh!
This is true.
What?
Considering she voices Applejack, I am inclined to agree with you. I think Ashley Ball's on a secret mission to Zimbabwe, though.
What's up with the pirates? The Aries of pirates? Do you know anything about that?
Do I know anything about the hiatus?
Yeah.
Well, it's a period of time when something. Yeah. So you're not asking me what a hiatus is. You're asking me what? Are you asking me?
I think the question is, do you know why there's a hiatus in between the episodes?
I don't know. Maybe that's a network decision. Maybe it's to build suspense.
Third one.
Equestria Girls, the Equestria Games.
Very, very busy at the old DHS factory. So I'm not really sure, but. Yes. Yeah.
My question is for Tabitha and Michelle. Now, we've already heard Twilight Sparkle say, winter is coming.
Winter's coming.
In your character, Princess Luna and Apple Bloom, I would like both of you to say, the night is dark and full of terrors.
We're meant for that.
The night is dark and full of terrors!
The night is dark and full of terrors.
The night is dark and full of terrors.
The night is dark and full of terrors.
Recently we had a really cool experience.
We were at Walmart and we were trying to find Halo 2, which is nowhere. And so we asked this guy, like, do you have Halo 2? He's like, oh, I don't know, like, how can I help you? And so we looked at
the... Yeah, one of the employees.
Yeah.
In fact, he was the employee that we were supposed to ask because he was, like, the And he held us everywhere, couldn't find it. It's like, I'm sorry guys, couldn't have helped. That's okay. We left.
3 hours later, this is sweet. It's like, I failed the show Reaver and Black Girl without finding Halo.
And then we met in the Brony Cam, like a couple of say like,
oh wow.
So great.
That's me.
Okay, so I was in Finland, and we had sessions set up to take photographs with people. And this guy, he took photographs of me, and when he was on the way out of the room, he said, "You're the stupidest woman alive." incredible affection. That was very flattering. But then, I think he may have worried about what, you know, saying it, because it might have offended me. So he wrote me a letter, and it said, I just wanted to clarify that when I say that you're stupid, I mean that some people who are geniuses are idiots, and you're a really big idiot.
So you're given $10 million, right? You're just given $10 million. But for the rest of your life, there is an invincible snail that is out to kill you. The moment it touches you, you die.
It touches us.
Yeah, the moment it touches us. And it's covered up to kill you, so it can outsmart you.
Okay.
Do you take the $10
million? Does the $10 million come with the snail?
Yes,
it comes with the snail. Or not honest, because that would just...
$10 million, the moment you ask someone to invent a suit that would protect you from
the snail. Yeah, but would you want to wear that all the time?
I think what you want to do is donate your $10 million to your enemy. And it's a bit devious, but...
So Gabe, take your $10
million. We're actually just about to offer you $10 million.
This question is for Tabitha. What would you say Rarity's favorite flavor of tea is?
Flavor of tea?
Yes.
What's wrong with just
tea?
There's so many different flavors of tea, though.
I quite like tea flavored tea.
Trivia, there is only one tea left, and the rest is just flavors.
Yes, I think they will find it. It's just one flavor of tea. And anyway, no! I got a question for Tabitha. If, I know the mantle is weaker than Twilight becomes an alcorn, but would Rarity say if she becomes an alcorn herself? But what would she say?
There was actually, and you'll never ever see it or hear it, but there was an outtake where they in the studio, and I have to tell you all, for telling you this, but I'll tell you anyway. outtake
like violence.
To show the animators of my reaction to Twilight. and it's maybe a little rude. So,
that's
it for you guys. Thank you.
Please don't kill me, Rarity.
This is for Tabitha. Because you voice both Rarity and Nightmare Moon, what do you think Nightmare Rarity would sound like?
Nightmare Rarity, huh?
I honestly don't know. I need to read it, but I suggest that I'd like to read that. I'm just going to put it out there to read that comic at a panel with everybody. I think that'd be fun. And we'll see what comes out of my face, because I don't know.
Thank you.
So this is a question directed mostly at Michelle, but if either of you could answer as well, that'd be okay. So thank you yesterday for the graphic detail of how you managed to keep Alpamoon's voice. So my question is, how do you keep your voice for singing?
I don't know. It's an interesting question. I have to think for once. That's not something I do often. I'd say it's quite similar. I don't really know how to answer that. It's just like a regular mimicry that I have to do. I just have to pitch my voice higher. And so it's better if I'm warmed up, so I can, because I sing like that. It's similar, I guess.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
This is for all of you who have worked in Michelle's, so I really just happened in Michelle's house. Good friends with other voice actors offset.
We braid each other's hair we should actually even use my lip gloss after I moved it.
Later at tea party.
I think in all seriousness, because the show has just grown,
which sprouts are the fastest? How does one do it?
So quickly now, I'm a big beat to stop going up into the sky. You find the little niggas on the loose.
We got the opportunity to spend casual time with the other voice actors because we're going to all these conventions. And so people like Tabitha and Andrea, I've gotten to see them so much because we go to so many conventions and it's really cool to have to travel together and stuff.
Cool.
I
can tell you a quick friendship-y story. At Andrea's wedding. So I went to Andrea's wedding, and I wore Spanx for the first time in my life. Those are the things that keep you ready for this jelly. They're the bum-hugging things. So they're like anti-acting pants, right? So Spanx, I was wearing some Spanx. So I kept some underpants. This is maybe TMI, but anyway. My purse because the Spanx made a noise as I walked, and it was a little irritating. So then when Andrea came down the aisle, and she looked like an angel, just in white, just absolutely gorgeous, of course I went, and I had nothing in my purse but a pair of underpants.
Oh my god.
Alright, so this one's for Michelle and Tabitha. What was your motivation?
Motivation for what?
What's happening?
Well, when you're just one above monkey. Your career choices are, I cannot do surgery, I can't. So it's really, it's that or stand on the street corner. And with the instruments and.
I started at a really young age.
wanted to naturally because I did so many stupid voices when I was younger. I got my mom, like, she'd read bedtime stories and all sorts of different crazy characters. And yeah, I don't know, I really, really enjoyed it. So I wanted to do more of it, and to do it professionally was cool. So I did it.
Yeah.
This is a question for Tabitha. In one of the episodes of My Little Pony, there was the one where Spike grows and grows until he's big. Thank you. I noticed that there was a veterinarian pony that you quite a lot about dogs. Was that in reference to your work with Martha Speaks?
No, they don't cross-reference, especially since they're not owned by the same studio. No, it wasn't. That was just a coinkydinky, as we say.
Okay, well, greetings again.
Greetings.
Mine is, if you could choose anybody in the industry to be a guest voice on the show, who?
Steve Crow.
Oh, yes.
I would choose Minnie Driver because she's an amazing voice actor and singer. And I love her voice.
Females. My question is, have you seen, and if you have, do you like the design of your characters in Equestria Girls?
I've seen a bit of the first one. It's fun. Sorry. That was a terrible answer.
Hello. I was wondering, especially you, Tabitha, because you were in Generation 3, what were your expectations about what the show would be like when you went into audition? And also for Tabitha, how did it feel different from Generation 3? But for,
Generation 3, it was very gentle. And I think it's partially why we exerted such mind control over generations. Because it was just, you know, very soft. And, you know, your little kids would sit in front of the TV and, you're pretty, no, you're pretty, and let's play. And that's, you know, basically it. But now, each of the characters in this, in, you know, our generations were much more clearly defined, not so much by external things like having a whistle or a hunchback or whatever it is, three eyes. As you know, that generation, the three-eyed ponies, because that was very short-lived.
What? Three-eyed ponies.
Okay.
Had something, more eyes, better. But this one, there's a little more depth to it. And when we auditioned for it, we just knew it was going to be different because we were told not to do anything that we had done before. And I sort of stayed away from anyone that had to sing. I think everyone had to sing.
Oh, it was California Girl.
Katy Perry.
And then they had Peter and everybody had
to sing California Girl. Yeah. It just triggered stampede, and people making out with fire hydrants. Not a dry stick in the house. So
good. Wow.
And since
the
voice Derpy for the
100th
episode, what is Derpy's favorite muffin?
Blueberry.
Blueberry.
I don't know. I really like any kind of muffin.
What is this fun?
This is a question for you, Tabitha. What is your favorite episode out of the series?
Dog and Pony Show.
It all starts with the Big Bang.
It was big and it went back. That's how I remember it. Okay, so I was putting up videos as a tot when YouTube first came out. I was 4 or 18. Yes, I remember.
4, that's quite impressive.
4, operating methods, the G-camera. I was doing videos, uploading sketches and stuff like that when I was younger. And then I joined the Navy, didn't do it for a while, and then I started doing animations for fun and uploading those and then songs and stuff. Are you talking specifically like our music or the sketches that we do?
Sketches.
Oh.
Okay, well.
What made us start that?
We just kind of do stupid things all the time, and it just kind of happens.
And one day we pointed a camera at ourselves.
Does anyone see Christoph and Schloff?
It started
off as us planning to do improv on the piano with characters called Maple and Stripes.
For obvious reasons.
Somehow in less than an hour that devolved so greatly into German characters who are out of their minds.
That was great, man.
Steve, no.
It was very, very interesting. So I didn't miss y'all. What did she do?
She put her hair up.
Very nice.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Can you do your best impression of Apple Blue? And Greenberg, can you try Vanishman?
Apple? Where's my cutie mark? Up in the
downloads of anyway, moving on. Next question.
Thank you,
sugar
buddy.
Oh, that was good question.
Yeah.
So we're almost out of time, so we have time for two more questions.
Good voice.
Good question.
It's been a really, really long time since I had to go through that, and the world's changed so much that I think I should really just hand it over to the person who's gone through it most recently.
I remember. It was 2 months ago.
So,
I'm with the characters, Caroline, me, Dunn, me, Michelle, and Happy, and all have the same agent. And what she did for me is she gave me some copy, some stuff to read over, and she wanted to hear not only the voices I could do, but the acting as well. There was, you know, I had to portray different emotions and stuff like that. And went into a small booth and just recorded me, just like you would if you were, you know, actually doing a gig. And the interview was really relaxing. She just talked to me. She just wanted to get to know me as a person, you know, have a good conversation, and see that I wasn't completely insane. And because I'm a good actor, she believed that I wasn't. Yeah, it was just, you know, be confident, relax, and, you know, do what you do and know you do it well, and you'll nail it. Hello.
Okay, so my question is for all of you. If you could write your own episode for the show, what would it be about and who would it focus on?
So first of all, I just want to say that Tabitha has written some scripts. Actual scripts, and they're really, really funny and really good. We recited one in Germany at Galacon, and it was so brilliant.
Absolutely.
She should be a writer on the show. It's not even funny. Seriously. So well, and so I have written a couple. Don't really want to say too much about that.
Well, I think something that people wonder a lot about is the back history of Celestia and Luna, because people always ask you guys those questions. And I think for the fans, I think you would love to see a history episode of way back.
Yeah.
You know, to young people, Celestia and Luna. Yes.
I'm really interested in all of the logic gaps.
Oh, yeah. Okay, you know what? My episode would be titled, Where Scoogaloo's Parents Be At?
I think we're going to wrap it up here.
Yeah.
Speed now?
Oh, you're not talking yet. And now we run to the lightning round.
Go. I have a question for all of you. What's the most annoying voice you can possibly make?
Oh, jeez.
What's the most annoying?
Hello?
Hello?
This is for Tabitha. Can you do a Nightmare Moon in a southern accent?
Oh, God!
This question is for Tabitha, so it might be a little bit dated, but after months and months of constantly bothering you to get her Twitter, what finally convinced you after Tara Strong bothered you so long?
I lost a bet.
Alright, so this is for every one of you. Who is best pony?
Everyone, you!
Alrighty.